Right, here we are today. Gonna paint up a skull head. Well, this is kind of a skull plaque, which actually comes from a full skull, but I moulded some up so you can like hang them on the wall. It looks like they're sort of coming out of the wall. So there's some previous videos with skulls, painting them in sort of metallic effects, but this one I want to paint up in like a natural looking boned skull. And first of all, I've primed or undercoated this concrete sculpture with acrylic paint, two coats, and it's white acrylic paint mixed in with a little bit of brown, so it just gives you just a slight off-white. And first of all, we're going to paint this. We're just going to fill in the sort of crevices with some brown or some burnt umber. And this is different to the dry brushing, so we're just going to paint it in and then wipe the excess paint off with a cloth. So I'm going to thin down some brown with some water and do just that. Okay, so this is thinned down, the brown paint is thinned down, relatively watery, and just sort of paint in. I'll start with the eyes, just paint that in. It doesn't really matter if you make any mistakes, just wipe it off. And we'll build this up in layers to try and get some kind of authentic look. Just damp down the cloth slightly. I don't want it too wet, but just a bit damp. Right, so we'll continue just filling in these areas. Right, okay, so that's where we're at. That's the first layer. Just let that dry off a bit. Give it 10-20 minutes, and then we'll do the same again and paint another coat of brown over the top. Okay, I'm not sure if I mentioned about the undercoat. It's probably best, well definitely best, to undercoat your item 24 hours in advance, or the night before, just to let the paint cure, because otherwise if you paint it, if you wipe off your wet paint, which is going over the top of the undercoat, after not letting the undercoat dry or cure properly, it tends to wipe off the undercoat as well, so which obviously you don't want. So leave it for 24 hours and that'll give you, that should be plenty. And then you can continue with adding your details. So anyway, so I'm going to add the second coat now and just build up these layers and do the same again with the brown paint. So that's where we're at the moment, so we'll let that dry off again. Might need a couple more coats just to sort of balance out the brown, and we'll just see how it goes. I'll let that dry and do some more painting when it's dried. Right, so this is going to be the third coat. I'm just going to put some thicker paint in the eye sockets, just towards the back, just to darken that up slightly, just towards the back. Maybe just a touch inside the nose. Just continue with the more watered down paint over the skull. Maybe one more coat, see how it's looking after that, but I think it's getting there. So I'll just let that dry and then we'll go for a fourth coat. We'll go for the fourth coat. Well, my paintbrush snapped towards the end, but I think that's probably telling me to stop. So what I'm going to do now is just put my finger into the cloth and just highlight some of the lighter areas, take away some of the paint on those highlights to bring that base coat through a bit more. And then it's pretty much done. Right, so there we are. That's pretty much done. I'll move the camera so you can see the skull. And I think that's turned out pretty well. I hope it's coming out okay on the camera. Right, so there he is. The battery just ran out then, so I just hung him on the wall while I just charged the camera up a little bit. So yeah, I'd say he's turned out pretty well. Quite happy with that. And I did some others with some different colours. There's another one hung on the wall here, which is sort of a mixture of blacks, browns and blues, whereas the one I did in this video is just white and brown, or white and burnt umber. So obviously you can experiment, and there's a metallic one down here, which I've got some videos on how to create these kind of effects. With the full version of this, a couple of patina videos, and just a dry brush metallic effect. I'll put those in the description, the links to the video, plus they'll be on the video somewhere as well. So there we are. I think that's quite natural looking. There we are. Thank you very much, and over and out.